Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. certifies the necessity of the bill seeking to create a sovereign wealth fund as urgent. House Bill 6608, or the Maharlika Investment Fund, has hurdled a second reading in the House of Representatives. This means it will most likely pass on third and final reading today. The palace says this will enable the establishment of a sustainable national investment fund to strengthen the government's investment activities. As of this afternoon, the number of co-authors of the bill is at 275.
The Philippine military releases a photo of Chinese vessels in the West Philippine Sea. This comes after it confirmed last week that Chinese militia ships have been inching closer to Palawan province. Bianca Dava now joins us on the line for details. Bianca?
Denise, the armed forces of the Philippines Western Command said around 12 Chinese vessels were seen around the eastern part of Sabina Shoal in the West Philippine Sea late November. The Westcom released today a photo of the said ships taken during an aerial patrol. Similar ships were also found on the western part of the shoal. Westcom added, similar Chinese vessels were still spotted in the same area on December 5. The photo comes a week after the Westcom reported that several Chinese vessels have been moving much closer to Palawan in recent months. Last week, Westcom Chief Vice Admiral Alberto Carlos confirmed the swarming presence of Chinese vessels in the West Philippine Sea. Carlos said they saw the vessels near Iroquois Reef and Sabina Shoal, which are well within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. The military official noted an average of 20 Chinese vessels were monitored in each area in the past couple of months. The swarming happened just weeks after the Philippines filed a diplomatic protest against China after the China Coast Guard reportedly seized rocket debris that the Philippine Navy had recovered and towed. In a statement just this week, the Department of National Defense said it was greatly concerned on the reported swarming of Chinese vessels in parts of the West Philippine Sea. But despite the reported swarming, DND officer in charge Jose Faustino Jr. maintained that Philippine military forces would continue to conduct routine maritime and aerial patrols in the West Philippine Sea. Denise?
Thank you, Bianca.
The Bureau of Jail Management and Penology now allowing families of prisoners to visit them personally in jails. This comes 2 years since face-to-face visitations were suspended due to the pandemic. But the BJMP says visitors should be fully vaccinated against COVID-19. Those who are unvaccinated due to health and religious belief reasons will be required to present a negative COVID test result. Visits should also be scheduled to prevent the influx of people in the jail facilities.
Well, unang-una, meron tayong listahan ng mga pamilya o immediate families ng mga PDL natin. Kinukuha na ito pagpasok pa lang nila doon sa mga facilities ng BJMP.
Opo.
So, yung immediate family, sila muna po yung priority natin. Kasi hindi natin pwedeng mapayagan 100% ng total jail population ay makabisita lahat ng pamilya, no? Importante yung health and security protocols na in-implement ng BJMP.
Visitation hours will be from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and from 8 a.m. to 12 noon and 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. on weekends. The U.S. Federal Reserve has raised interest rates by a smaller 50 basis points as inflation in the country showed signs of easing. But they did signal at least an additional 75 basis point hike by the end of 2023. Fed Chairman Jerome Powell says the speed of rate rises is less critical now.
Thank you very much.
He adds it remains unclear if the U.S. economy will slip into recession, saying more evidence is needed to prove inflation is on a sustained downward path.
To the extent we need to keep rates higher and keep them there for longer and inflation, you know, moves up higher and higher, I think that narrows the runway. But lower inflation readings, if they persist in time, could certainly make it more possible. So I don't think anyone knows whether we're going to have a recession or not. And if we do, whether it's going to be a deep one or not. It's just, it's not knowable.